Hello students, welcome to Easy Biology Tutorials. Yesterday we had already covered up with the topic that is synaptic generation and conduction of the impulse. In that video we had already read about the importance and the meaning of resting potential, the action potential and the propagation of the action potential. तो वो जो हमने प्रोसीजर किया था दैट वाज अबाउट दैट हाउ द जनरेशन ऑफ द इम्पल्स टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू अ न्यूरॉन. लेकिन एक न्यूरॉन से दूसरे न्यूरॉन तक भी तो सिनेप्टिक ट्रांसमिशन होगा, ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ इम्पल्स होगा. वो कैसे होगा उसके बारे में वी आर गोइंग टू रीड नाउ. स्टूडेंट्स, सबसे पहले बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अप विद द टॉपिक यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज अ साइनैप्स एंड व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द साइनैप्स. So basically students, synapse is of two types, electrical and chemical. Synapse is the functional junction between the two neurons. Ye dekho students, in the diagram you are able to see. In the diagram you can see, this is the dendrite and this is the synaptic knob of the next neuron. This is the space. A space is filled. Let me fill this space with the help of the pink color. A space is left between the one neuron and the next neuron, and this space is known as synapse. Students, this space is known as synapse. This is one synaptic knob. This is the other synapse. This is the dendrite of the other neuron. So you can read about the synapse. Synapse is a functional junction between two neurons, and it is of two types. According to कि वो कैसे impulse transmit कर रहे हैं. Transmission of the impulse is with the help of electricity or with the help of the chemical acetylcholine. The synapse is divided into two types. First kind of synapse is the electrical synapse. Next kind of synapse is the chemical synapse. Hanji. So let us read again. Electrical synapse. What is electrical synapse? In this, the membranes of pre and post synaptic neurons are in close proximity. Students, see. This is a presynaptic neuron, मतलब एक न्यूरॉन का साइनाप्स एंड दूसरे न्यूरॉन के साइनाप्स का पोस्ट सिनाप्टिक पार्ट. एक पार्ट जो साइनाप्स से पहले आ रहा है दैट इज प्री, एक जो बाद में आ रहा है दैट इज पोस्ट. ठीक है, प्री और पोस्ट मेम्ब्रेन्स आर इन क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी. क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी का मतलब क्या है स्टूडेंट्स? इट इज वेरी क्लोज टू ईच अदर. So impulse transmission is similar to the transmission along an axon. Electrical synapse के अंदर electricity के through nerve conduction हो रही है. It is बिल्कुल similar to the transmission along an axon. जैसे axon में transmission होती है बिल्कुल वैसे ही electrical synapse के अंदर transmission हो रही है. Impulse transmission with the help of chemical synapse is fast, and electrical synapse are not found or very rarely found in human system. In the human beings, basically, in the human beings, the kind of synapse or the kind of synapse transmission that is found, that is chemical synapse and electrical synapse is very very rare. Hanji. Now, students, we are going to read about the next part. Chemical synapse. In this, there is a fluid-filled space that is synaptic cleft. Chemical synapse ke case mein students hota kya hai basically? There is a synaptic cleft. Matlab ye jo space present hai in between the neurons, uske andar ab ek fluid-filled hai. Ab dekho students, agar fluid-filled hai, to electrical transmission ho paega? No, nahi ho paega. Thus, प्री-साइनाप्टिक एंड पोस्ट-साइनाप्टिक न्यूरॉन के बीच में जो स्पेस है वहां पे ट्रांसमिशन इज नॉट पॉसिबल. द प्री-साइनाप्टिक रीजंस हैव स्वेलिंग्स कॉल्ड द सिनाप्टिक नॉब्स और द सिनाप्टिक बटन्स. दे कंटेन द सिनाप्टिक वेसिकल्स. सिनाप्टिक नॉब्स तो सबके पास होते हैं, उसमें क्या होते हैं? सिनाप्टिक वेसिकल्स. स्टूडेंट्स, these synaptic vesicles secrete the neurotransmitters acetylcholine or adrenaline. The neurotransmitter, the name of the neurotransmitter is acetylcholine or the adrenaline. And chemical synapse ke through transmission kahan se ho raha hai? With the help of chemical. And that chemical is a neurotransmitter adrenaline or acetylcholine. Hanji. अब स्टूडेंट्स, यू टेल कि केमिकल साइनाप्स के अंदर इलेक्ट्रिकल ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ इंपल्स क्यों नहीं हो सकता? क्योंकि वहां पे फ्लूइड फिल्ड है और फ्लूइड एक क्या कर लेता है, बैरियर बना लेता है जिससे इलेक्ट्रिकल इंपल्स ट्रांसपोर्ट नहीं हो पाती. सो फर्स्टली द इलेक्ट्रिकल साइनाप्स इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू द केमिकल साइनाप्स. And then it is again converted into the electrical synapse. ठीक है जी? ऐसे करके ये काम होता है. And in this way, the nerve impulsion conduction takes place. Yes. Impulse reaches at the axon terminal and goes to the synaptic vesicles. Then these impulses from the axon terminal coming to the synaptic vesicles bind on the plasma membrane and release the neurotransmitter. This neurotransmitter diffuses along with the help of synaptic cleft. Diffuses along the synaptic cleft and combines with the receptors on the postsynaptic membrane. In this way, it enters the next neuron and opening of the ion channels, allowing the entry of the ions and thus generating the action potential in that case. This action potential may be excitatory or inhibitory. It can be exciting. It can be exciting ki wo kya kar raha hai, further generation kar raha hai, action potential ko generate kar raha hai. या फिर इनहिबिटरी भी एक्शन हो सकता है केमिकल का, कि जनरेशन हुई हुई है ऑलरेडी इनसाइड द न्यूरॉन बट दिस इज इनहिबिटिंग द न्यूरॉन सो दैट देयर इज नो मोर एक्शन पोटेंशियल जनरेटेड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टैकल अबाउट द ह्यूमन न्यूरल सिस्टम. एंड इन द ह्यूमन न्यूरल सिस्टम वी आर हैविंग द सेंट्रल न्यूरल सिस्टम, सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम CNS, and the peripheral neural system or peripheral nervous system or the PNS. C, this is a human body. It is having a brain and the spinal cord. The regions where it is having a brain and a spinal cord, they are in between the body. Matlab, they are located in the center of the body. But in the peripheral nervous system, there are nerves. And these nerves are on the periphery or the sides of the body. So from this, you can remember that human nervous system consists of two parts. These are the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system consists of the brain and the spinal cord. And the peripheral neural system consists of the somatic neural system and the autonomic neural system. So, because of the presence of the brain and the spinal cord in the center of the body, these are the part of central nervous system. And because of the presence of the nerves at the periphery of the body, these are the part of peripheral nervous system. Okay, students, now let us go to the next slide and read what is written further about this. Brain. Brain is the major part of the nervous system or the neural system, and it is present in the central nervous system. It is protected in the cranial cavity. Cranial cavity is the cavity present in the head region, jiske andar brain located hai. And brain is covered by the brain box or the skull. And it has a three layered connective tissue membranes called the cranial meninges. Cranial meninges are the layers around the brain. These are the layers around the brain. And students, these layers take care of the protection of the brain. The first and the outermost layer is dura mater. The middlemost layer is arachnoid matter. And the innermost layer is the pia mater. Outer dura mater, middlemost arachnoid matter, and innermost pia mater. So you can say that the central nervous system is having three membranes, the outer dura mater, middle arachnoid mater, innermost pia mater. यहाँ पे arachnoid and pia mater के in between क्या होता है students? Space filled between pia mater and arachnoid mater is filled with cerebrospinal fluid. A fluid is filled in between the arachnoid and the pia mater, and this fluid is known as cerebrospinal fluid. Now you have to see that the cerebro is the word used for brain. Let me write you cerebro, word for brain. And spinal is word for spinal cord. Okay, students? So, cerebrospinal fluid is the fluid-filled space that is filled in between the brain as well as the spinal cord. You have to remember that this brain ke andar bhi present hai and this spinal cord ke andar bhi present hai. And short form, we can say it as CSF. Now, The brain consists of the three parts. The first, or the uppermost part of the brain, is known as the forebrain. The middlemost part of the brain is known as the midbrain. The last part, or behind part of the brain, is known as the hindbrain. We can also say this is the forebrain, this is the midbrain, and this is the hindbrain. Okay, students? Now, along with the name of the parts, you have to remember forebrain is also known as prosencephalon. Midbrain is also known as mesencephalon. Hindbrain is also known as the rhombencephalon. So, what did you learn? Forebrain is the prosencephalon, midbrain is the mesencephalon, and rhombencephalon is the next name for the hindbrain. Yes, students. So now let us start with the prosencephalon, or the forebrain. Forebrain, it is the anterior part. Anterior part ka matlab kya hai, students? You have to remember that is the aage wala. Anterior part is the we can also say it as close in front. आगे से जो भी चीज हमें बहुत क्लोज दिखती है दैट इज द इंटीरियर पार्ट. जो आगे से हमें पीछे मतलब बहुत ज्यादा दूर दिखती है दैट इज द पोस्टीरियर पार्ट. सो फोरब्रेन इज द एंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन. दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द प्रोसेंसेफेलन. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द टू पार्ट्स, फर्दर द टू पार्ट्स, द सेरेब्रम एंड द डायएंसेफेलन. स्टूडेंट्स, ब्रेन जो होता है दैट is a highly folded and convoluted tissue organ. Basically, brain is an organ. It is made up of highly convoluted tissues. So cerebrum is the part that is a highly convoluted part. Diencephalon is the part that consists of the thalamus, the hypothalamus and the thalamus. So let us read about this in the next slide. Before going to the next slide, let me show you this is the forebrain. ये आगे वाला part है सबसे ज्यादा. तो this is the forebrain. This is the middlemost part and it is also known as the midbrain. This is the most posterior part and it is also known as the hindbrain. Forebrain. Forebrain is the largest part of the brain. It has two cerebral hemispheres. It is made up of two cerebral hemispheres. See, this is the first hemisphere, this is the second hemisphere. What is the hemisphere? Sphere जो होता है वो पूरा round structure होता है. जब जो आधा rounded structure होता है students, that is known as the hemisphere. Now, these two cerebral hemispheres are held together by a tract of nerve fibers, and these nerve fibers are known as corpus callosum. Now, from this you get a very important question, that is, what is corpus callosum? You have to answer the nerve tissue connecting the two cerebral hemispheres. Okay, students? Yes. Then is the prosencephalon. Prosencephalon, outer part of the cerebrum, is called the cerebral cortex. It has convolutions and depressions and is formed of gray matter. Gray is the color due to presence of the neuron cell bodies or the non-myelinated axon fibers. Jo myelinated axon fibers the students, they were making the white matter. And the non-myelinated, they are making the gray matter. Or we can also say that gray matter is due to the presence of neuron cell bodies. Now, inner part is formed with the help of the white matter, and it is consisting of the myelinated axon fibers. Outer part is consisting of the non-myelinated fibers. Inner part is consisting of the myelinated fibers. Yes, so now cerebrum ke parts dekh lete hain. Cerebral jo cortex hai, that is the outer part. Kidney ke andar bhi humne padha tha, there was a cortex and there was a medulla. Medulla was the inner part, cortex was the outer part. So in the brain also the cortex is the outer part. Yes. This cortex or the outer part is consisting of the three parts. First is the motor area. Students, the motor word is used for voluntary organs. Jo bhi cheez ko hum control kar sakte hain, that is motor. Motor nerves. Motor nerves means jo bhi nerves hain hamari skeletal muscle ke saath lagi hui hain, jisko hum apni thinking ke hisab se control कर सकते हैं, they are the voluntary nerves. ठीक है जी? Yes. Yes. So, motor area is controlling the voluntary movement of the muscles. Sensory area is controlling the sensory movement of a muscle. That हमने क्या किया? हमारे जो sense organs हैं, they are 5 in number. Eyes, ears, skin, nose and tongue. In kisi bhi cheez se, jaise ki aapne bahut hi zyada koi kadvi cheez kha li, you had swallowed something very bitter, to aap kya karoge, usko vomit out kar doge or you will spit it out. So what is this? This is a kind of stimulus that is, this is a kind of response in respect to a stimulus. वो स्टिमुलस क्या था? द स्टिमुलस वाज कि ये आपने कोई बहुत ही ज्यादा कड़वी चीज खा ली है. जो किसने रिसीव की? स्टूडेंट्स, दैट वाज रिसीव्ड बाय योर गस्टेटरी रिसेप्टर्स. गस्टेटरी मतलब टंग. हां जी, सो टंग ने रिसीव किया, माउथ ने स्पिट किया. ये सब क्या हुआ? ये सब कंट्रोल किया सेंसरी नर्वस सिस्टम ने by the cerebral part of the brain. ठीक है जी? तो हम cerebrum के बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं. आपको भूलना नहीं है कि हम cerebrum के बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं. Cerebrum basically कर क्या रहा है? हमारा control of the various organs. Association area. It is neither clearly sensory nor motor in function. Nor motor in function basically. कि ये ना ही काम कर रहा है सेंस करने का, ना ही काम कर रहा है मोटर होने का. ठीक है, ना ही वॉलेंट्री ना ही सेंसरी. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द बेसिक थिंग. आप यहाँ पे सेरेब्रम के पार्ट्स देख सकते हो. दिस इज द सेंसरी एरिया, दिस इज द मोटर एरिया, दिस इज द एसोसिएशन एरिया. एसोसिएशन डिफरेंट डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स में प्रेजेंट है इन द वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. जैसे यहाँ पे विजुअल कॉर्टेक्स है, विजुअल कॉर्टेक्स की नीचे वर्बल एसोसिएशन एरिया है, स्पेशल एसोसिएशन एरिया, Broca's area, prefrontal cortex के नीचे volitional association area, then the auditory cortex and thirds. आपको जस्ट इसका अच्छे से मतलब आपको याद नहीं करना है इसको, यू जस्ट हैव टू नो द बेसिक एंड द बेसिक्स ऑफ अबाउट दिस सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. इंटीग्रेटिंग एक्टिविटीज ऑफ डिफरेंट सेंटर्स ऑफ सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स कंट्रोल इंटेलिजेंस, मेमोरी, जजमेंट, लर्निंग, थिंकिंग एंड आर्टिकुलेट स्पीच. हमारा सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स है, यहाँ पे इतने सारे रीजन्स प्रेजेंट है स्टूडेंट्स. मोटर एसोसिएशन एरिया है, ब्रोकास एरिया है, प्रीफ्रंटल एरिया है, विजुअल एसोसिएशन एरिया है, प्राइमरी विजुअल कॉर्टेक्स है, प्राइमरी ऑडिटरी एरिया है, ऑडिटरी एसोसिएशन एरिया है, मतलब सेंसरी, देन एसोसिएशन एंड देन द मोटर एरियाज. सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स में ये तीनों रीजन्स प्रेजेंट है एंड तीनों रीजन्स जब प्रेजेंट हो के ये इंटीग्रेटेड एंड प्रॉपर कोऑर्डिनेटेड मैनर में काम करते हैं तो हमारी थिंकिंग को, इंटेलिजेंस को, लर्निंग को, जजमेंट को एंड स्पीच को रेगुलेट करते हैं. ठीक है, सो द ब्रेन, द सेरेब्रल पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन प्लेज अ लॉट एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पार्ट इन अवर coordination of the integrated activities. Yes. Okay, students, so that was all about today's topic. I hope you liked it. I hope you got it. If you have any doubt, you can ask me directly. So, I hope that आपको समझ आ रहा है. पढ़ने के साथ साथ आपको रीडिंग भी बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी है, स्पेशल द एनसीईआरटी रीडिंग. एनसीईआरटी रीडिंग अगर आप नहीं करोगे देन दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू गेन गुड मार्क्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, थैंक यू, दैट वॉज ऑल फॉर टूडे एंड वी आर गोइंग टू एंड अवर टॉपिक टूडेज लेक्चर, टूडेज क्लास हेयर ओनली. सो यस स्टूडेंट्स, thank you and have a nice day.